Now is Dr. Robert Murphy. He's a professor of infectious diseases at Northwestern University Feinberg School of Medicine. Good morning, doctor.
Hey, good morning.
Well, I mean, isn't this part of what's expected in the future and in new variants coming out?
Absolutely, Larry. This is just going to happen over and over again, starting with alpha, beta, gamma. We had mu, we had lambda, all these different variants. Some of them don't take, and some of them do. This one is taking. This is BA4 and BA5, discovered at Stellenbosch University Medical Center in South Africa a couple months ago, as you mentioned. It now accounts for 13% of the virus in the United States.
But the good news is hospitalizations are down. Is that because of this Paxlovid? Is it, or do we have to worry about things getting worse again in the fall, or will the drugs keep that from happening?
Robin, this is a great and astute observation in that, you know, we're having all these cases, but the hospitalization rate is not so high and may actually be leveling off or going down in some areas. And it's due to a variety of things. One is Paxlovid, the drug that you mentioned. That cuts hospitalization rates by 90%. Doesn't matter whether you're vaccinated or not. If you're at risk, if you're at a high-risk person for getting sick, this drug really, really helps, and there's more drugs coming after that. But also, the vaccination rate in the United States is creeping up. 78% of people have had at least one shot, 66% have had two shots, and 47% of eligible people taking the vaccine have had a booster shot. All that together is really what's making these numbers look better.
Talk about Novavax and why we'd want older technology.
Well, yeah, Novavax got approved to distribute in the United States. It's already approved in a couple other countries. It is not this mRNA technology that a lot of people, I think, with no reason, are worried about. It's an older technology. It has an adjuvant to it. It just has some proteins in there, the way that they have made all the vaccines in the past. So, you know, some people may feel, you know, a little more comfortable with that vaccine, but they still have shown a couple of cases, very few, of the myocarditis, the inflammation around the heart, especially in younger men.
Before we let you go, quickly, let's touch on monkeypox. A lot of people confused how you get it, how dangerous it is. If you could just do your best to wrap that up.
Well, that's an evolving story. So far, nobody has died from monkeypox outside of the African setting, but there's over 1,000 cases now reported and another 1,000 under investigation right now. So there's a couple thousand floating around, and they're all over the place. There's an interesting article from yesterday showing that maybe it even can aerosolize, because some of the cases, there's just no, people didn't come in contact with anybody, and they're getting it. So it may even aerosolize. So the CDC has this kind of lukewarm recommendation about wearing masks if you're around people with monkeypox, which I think would make sense anyway. You know, that just is another wrench in the system.
All right. Dr. Murphy, thanks for being with us again. Dr. Murphy still answers COVID-19 questions Tuesday on Northwestern University's Institute for Global Health Facebook page. You can also submit questions via Facebook message or email, and you can check out Dr. Murphy in the Explore Global Health podcast. Thanks, doctor.
Thank you.
Thank you. Have a good weekend.
You too. Hey, Paul.
Hi, guys. Not a bad